Hi, I'm Satoru Katsumata. Today, I'll present our paper, Stronger Baselines for Grammatical Error Correction Using a Pre-trained Encoder-Decoder Model. Grammatical Error Correction is automatic correction of grammatical errors in the text. Most works regard this task as a translation task and use encoder-decoder architectures to convert ungrammatical sentences to grammatical ones. Strong encoder-decoder models for GC are pre-trained with a large amount of artificially generated data, commonly referred to as pseudo data. How to use pseudo data in GC? First, make error correct sentence pair by introducing artificial error to a monolingual corpus. Then, pre-train the encoder-decoder model with pseudo data. Some researchers investigate how to make pseudo data suitable for GC tasks. For example, Kion et al. Generated a pseudo corpus using back translation and achieved stronger results for English GC. In this presentation, pre-training using pseudo data aimed at a GC task is referred to as task-oriented pre-training. The task-oriented pre-training is achieved strong GC result. However, this approach have an issue. These task-oriented pre-training approaches require extensive use of pseudo parallel corpus. Specifically, Kiyono et al. And Kaneko et al. Use 70 million sentence pairs. And it takes time to create the pseudo parallel corpus. Specifically, Nabraba and Straka introduced word and character level errors into a sentence in monolingual corpus. These errors are based on spell checker and they control how much error is introduced as a hyperparameter specific to the target GC languages. So this approach requires time-consuming pre-training of GC models using a pseudo corpus. In this study, we determined the effectiveness of publicly available pre-trained encoder-decoder models for GC. Specifically, we investigated pre-trained models without the need for pseudo data. We explored pre-trained model, bidirectional and autoregressive transformers called BART, BART for short. Liu et al. Proposed multilingual BART, we explored it too. In this paper, pre-training aimed at various tasks is referred to as generic pre-training as opposed to task-oriented pre-training. Why did we focus on the generic pre-trained model? For example, we want to make a certain language GC model such as Japanese. You need to prepare the extensive, maybe 70 million pseudo corpus and pre-trained encoder-decoder model using it. It's very hard. If generic pre-trained model is effective for GC task, you don't need to pre-train. Need only fine-tuning. So we investigate the effectiveness of generic pre-trained models for GC in some languages. BART is pre-trained by predicting an original sequence, given a masked and shuffled sequence for English. The noisy input for pre-training is created in two ways, text inferring and sentence permutation. Text inferring introduces masked tokens with various lengths. Sentence permutation shuffles sentences in the original sequence. In this example, swap the first sentence and the second sentence. BART is pre-trained by reconstructing the original sequence from these noisy inputs. Multilingual BART is pre-trained by the same as English BART. In order to identify the language in input sequence, a special token is used. So when we use multilingual BART for German GC, we set a special token representing German as shown in the figure. We conduct GC experiments in some languages to investigate the effectiveness of generic pre-trained models. For English GC, we compare fine-tuned BART results with previous work. This work used task-oriented pre-trained models. German, Czech, and Russian GC, we compare fine-tuned multilingual BART results with previous work. This work also uses the task-oriented pre-trained model. We use the dataset described in table for fine-tuning. Please remember the Russian dataset is small compared to other languages. This is English GC result using single model. In Condon 40 and Bear, the BERT model is better than the model proposed by Kyoto et al. And the results are comparable to those reported by Kaneko et al. So, the BERT model achieved results comparable to current strong results despite only required fine tuning. This is English GC result using Ensemble model. The figures in parentheses refer to the difference from the single model. Our ensemble model was slightly better than our single model or worse in JFLAG. We believe that the reason for ineffectiveness of the ensemble method is that each model is not significantly different because the initial weights are the same as those of the BERT model, and these only affect minor changes such as training data order and so on. This is German, Czech, and Russian results using single model. In the German GC task, the Multilingual BERT model achieved 4.45 f 0.5 points lower than the task-oriented model. The Czech GC task, the Multilingual BERT model achieved 6.65 f 0.5 points lower than the task-oriented model. This may be because task-oriented model is present with only the target language, whereas Multilingual BERT is present with 25 languages, resulting in the information of other languages being included as noise. According to German and Czech results, although it is not good as task-oriented pre-trained model, but Multilingual BERT models are considered to show sufficiently high performance for several languages without using a pseudo corpus. Considering Russian GC, the Multilingual BERT model shows much lower scores. This may be because the training data for Russian GC are scarce compared to those of German or Czech. To investigate the effect of corpus size, we additionally fine-tuned the Multilingual BERT model with a 10 million pseudo corpus. Multilingual BERT with pseudo corpus is much higher than without pseudo corpus. This result supports our hypothesis. We compare the BERT model with Kaneko et al.'s model for common error types. This figure is the result in BERT test. BERT is superior to Kaneko et al. In punctuation and determinant errors. In particular, punctuation is 5.6 f0.5 points better. BERT is pretend to correct the shuffled and masked sequence, so that this model learns to place punctuation adequately. Kaneko et al. Report better results for other errors, except for determinant. It is difficult for the BERT model to correct these errors, because BERT uses shuffled and masked sequence as noise in pre-training, not using character-level errors. Kaneko et al. Introduces character errors into the pseudo corpus as task-oriented encoder-decoder pre-training. This is the reason why the BERT model is inferior to Kaneko et al. In these errors. Here is conclusion. We introduced a generic pre-trained encoder-decoder model, BERT for GC. The fine-tuned BERT achieved remarkable results, which were comparable to the current strong results in English GC. Although it is not good as SOTA, fine-tuned Multilingual BERT exhibited high performance in other languages. These results imply that BERT is a simple baseline model for pre-trained GC methods because it only requires fine-tuning as training. That's all. Thank you for listening.